It's good news for the regions with a number of businesses able to open up from midnight, but opening and shutting has taken a toll.
We're just over it. We're thankful that we're over it. Regional has got no cases. Janona, come on, give us a break.
And there's relief for students who'll be able to return to the classroom.
It's really exciting to be able to see my friends again. And whilst it is a surprise, it's a nice one because I definitely thought that this was going to be much longer.
We do have a conservative approach to these things. We don't want this virus to spread, but this is very positive news and speaks to the fact that we do have a degree of containment around these cases.
The five reasons to leave home will no longer apply, as well as the 5 kilometre travel limit. The Premier has ruled out a ring of steel, but 1,400 police will be out in force to ensure Melburnians don't break the rules.
So anyone trying to sneak out of Melbourne and drive through the back roads, I applaud you not to do it. We will be out in enforcement in all areas.
Of Victoria's 11 new cases, 7 are connected to the Caroline Springs Shopping Centre. The whole centre is now listed as a Tier 2 site.
We are quite concerned about a number of positive cases we've now identified from different stores associated with different movements in the shopping centre. And as we've seen before here in Victoria, we do need to ensure that we run all those little outbreaks to ground.
The community heeding the message to get tested as a childcare centre was added to the growing list of exposure sites. Overnight, the Joan Kerner Women's and Children's Hospital was listed after a positive case visited there last Friday. The state's vaccination program has also been ramped up. The country's first drive-through vaccination clinic has been set up in Melbourne's West, administering Pfizer jabs.
We've already gone through the process of checking in, so it's been fine. It's been really easy.
Being from Bacchus Marsh, only 10 minutes down the road, just hopped on, created my account, and I was done in 15 minutes, booking for 12:30.
Queensland is also boosting its vaccination program. A new mass vaccination hub will be set up in Brisbane as the state is set to get additional Pfizer doses this week.
We want to see as many people in Queensland vaccinated as quickly and as safely as possible. So there are now additional options that will be open.
Concerns remain for Cairns, which is in a 3-day lockdown after it's believed a taxi driver was infected by a marine pilot who tested positive last week.
It's really, really important that people in Cairns, any symptoms at all, don't wait for a call from Queensland Health. Just come forward and get tested.
In the southeast, which only just reopened after an 8-day lockdown, masks and strict social distancing remain in place. And for the first time, students will have to wear masks at high school. Gloria Kalesh, SBS World News.